Hey, in this one I would like to show you how you can have anonymous structs or arrays or just any kind of type you want. You can pass them anonymously to functions or to variables without declaring them previously. So here you can see in my example that I have a struct vec2, and then I have a small function that scale sum that operates that does some operation on it with a scalar. And here I have a sum that takes an array, its length, and computes the sum of all its elements. And the way you would usually do this would be struct vec2, and then v, then vx is equal to 2, and then vy is equal to 3. And then let's see. Printf d of and let's do results into scale sum of let's say we want to do that by 4, and then we do v here, and then here we print results like so, and you can see that it does what you would expect. But actually, what you can do is instead you can have this up. Int result. Like so, and as you can see, we don't need the struct here anymore. We can embed the struct into the function call itself. And this is extremely useful when obviously you don't use this every day. But if you have very small structs, for example, a very small vector like so, it's quite handy to not have to declare it. Before, and it saves a bit of space and makes it clearer if it's smaller. And as you can see, it behaves differently because I changed the value, but if I put it back to 4, it should behave exactly the same. And same thing for arrays or any kind of data types. So here I call the sum function with an array directly into its argument, and then the length of the array is just normal. So let's do R or maybe S for sum. And if I print sum, as you can see, it does the sum and it compiles, and it's all fine and well. And of course, you can have that for array of structs or structs into array, like. Whatever the type is, you can do this and embed them like so in arguments. And I think this, although I don't know why you would want to use this, but I think it also works if you want to just declare a variable. So if you do int a x is equal to this, I think that would work. Array from non-constant array expression. Maybe if I make it a pointer, then it's correct. Okay, but this has to do just with the fact that it's the array cannot be initialized from something that is not constant. Apparently, this is not. But yeah, let's try with struct vec2 v, and then let's copy paste up. Let's paste all this. And as you can see, you can have the vector like so declare a variable like this as well. Although, yeah, I still don't see any use for this, but you can do it. So yeah. Anyway, that was the slight shortcut when you have small arrays or small struct, and you want to make it a bit smaller. That's what you can do. That's it. See you in the next one.